You're acting like I'm incapable of being a mom, but I'm raising two children of my own.
Don't start yelling at me.
I'm tired of you acting like I'm not good enough for her.
Don't start yelling at me.
She's my daughter.
It has nothing to do with you not being good enough.
The conversation kind of escalated quickly. Basically, my mom and my grandpa are arguing and yelling at each other.
Shannon just yells for no reason at everybody.
So I decided to go down and get Timmy so he wouldn't have to be around all that drama.
Nobody said you weren't capable.
It's so hard for you guys to believe that she just wanted to live with me. Doesn't matter what I've done, how much progress I've made, or where I am in my life at this moment, I will never be good enough for her.
I'm not talking about
that.
What I'm talking about.
Yes, it is true.
No, what I'm talking about.
It's always been true.
I understand she's upset, so I understand what she's saying, but I feel like she should also understand that I'm not doing this to hurt her. This is nothing against her. It's just, you know, I'm doing what's best for me, Timmy, and Kaylin, and nobody can change my mind on that.
I know that I let her come here when she was 5. I made that choice. I gave up a lot, and I know we're where we are now because of that.
Okay, but you made the best decision for her.
I know I did, and it was the hardest choice I ever made. And now I'm trying to be there for her, and I can't, no matter what I do.
Let me ask you something. Do you really think Timmy and Michaela are better off at your house than they are here?
Yes, I do.
Why are they better off at your house?
What she said.
I want her to answer the question.
I'm not gonna answer the question.
Because you don't have an answer.
Do you want me to answer it? Because I will.
Okay, yeah, answer it.
I don't think that it's weird or strange for Max to be so excited to have a family, but I think it's a part of his life that he's missing and he's like trying to fill that void. Even though he is the father of the baby, he doesn't need to be involved in every aspect of Chloe's life at this point. And if that means him missing out on the baby shower, you know, so be it.
But of course I can come while we're open presents, right?
I'm the one having the baby, so I'm gonna open the presents.
You can do whatever you want to do. I don't care. Do you?
Chloe told me this whole time, yeah, of course you're allowed the baby shower. It's our baby. And then her mom's like, you know, you're not coming to the baby shower. And I was just like,
kind of made my heart like drop because like I'm the dad of the baby, and I thought, like, I was gonna go, and I was super excited, and it kind of just felt like a daggers to the heart type thing.
Well, I know you guys were talking the other day. Are you guys gonna go to a class? Are you guys going to a break?
I
want to
go to a class. Yeah, we need
obviously,
to sign up.
Obviously, yeah, we need to sign up for a class.
And what are you gonna do when you get there? What are you gonna do when you get there?
Well,
promise me
you two
will do this one thing, and what is it I'm gonna ask you to do?
What?
Class? Listen.
Oh,
just
I was like,
listen to what they're
to.
Telling you. Don't have the answers. Don't know everything. Because that's what it's there for. Make you think a little bit. Make you get a better understanding.
Right.
It's important.
Yeah, that's
important.
What the doctor was
telling. And I hope they
telling.
Include,
oh my God.
Giving that, who'd I interrupt?
Me. All the time. Our doctor was telling us that the birth classes, it'll help us during labor more. Water. Techniques in labor and stuff.
Yeah. Whether like how like I can be like a good dad and be there to support her.
Well, no, the birthing classes is for how to, it's like gives me techniques on like
breathing
and getting through actual labor.
But
it's like
I'm
nothing about like parenting.
But what I'm, no, not parenting, I'm saying me like holding your hand,
yeah,
like
you
me
just
using
have to be
techniques
there for
to help
Max,
you
she
get
might not
through
even
it.
Want you near her.
Might not.
She might not even want, I didn't.
She told me she wants.
Well, I don't know what I'm gonna
but,
be
but
like.
You don't know. Like, honestly, she might be like, you did this to me, get your butt over there. If she says do this, I'll do it. Don't argue it. I'm just trying to help you. Why are you telling me not to touch you? Don't talk back, because it's gonna
that's
just.
Not, no, that's I, not, no, that has nothing to do with birth. That's just life.
Somebody's phone's going off.
Oh, it's Diego.
What's he up to?
I asked him if he could come over and do this morning. And then he just texted me, wait, why? And I didn't say anything back. And he was just like, okay, whatever.
So is he coming over or not?
Probably not, because I never texted him back.
Diego is a junior in high school and going to be the father of my grandbaby. I don't dislike Diego. I just don't think he's the right one for my daughter. I think that she needs somebody that is supportive, that isn't so hateful all the time. He may wake up tomorrow and change and be that person, but as of right now, I just don't see that happening.
If you were not pregnant, would you still be with Diego?
Honestly, with the way he's treating me right now, no. But since the fact, like, that I kind of grew up without a father, I was promised that I would never have my children grow up without a father. And so I just never wanted that for my kids.
I would hope that the two of you would not be together if there wasn't a baby. And I don't think that it's right to stay together because of the baby. I tried the same thing with your dad. I stayed 4 years trying to make it work so that you had a mom and a dad together. And it just continued to get worse and worse.
I understand what she's saying, but like...
And I do get it way more than you would think I do.
It took you 4 years with my dad. I've only been with him for a year.
But at the price of your child.
I get that, but you had a child too with my dad, and so...
And I left earlier, and you've seen what it did to you.
I'm just saying there's could
be hope. Break the cycle.
I'm saying there could be hope, Mom.
I wish there was, but I don't see it. You are the only one that sees it.